the same institute. And there you can see the major areas of activity of the Mental Health Research Institute. The primary focus, and in fact the exclusive focus of the institute, is on the development of drugs for the treatment of psychiatric patients. David Kopilov is the institute director, who's a psychiatrist, and Nick Saunders was the dean of Monash University and is also a senior member of the National Health and Medical Research Council. If one looks at the history of the term schizophrenia, one finds that the term schizophrenia was first used by the Swiss psychiatrist Eugene Bleuler in the early 1900s. This was at the time of major expansion of the eugenics movement under sponsorship of the Rockefeller Institutes and the Rockefeller Corporations and the Carnegie Corporation. The Rockefeller Corporation were responsible for setting up psychiatric diagnosis and treatment programs around the world. Here you can see that one of the corporate sponsors was Janssen-Cilag, which is a Belgian company that market an antipsychotic drug by the name of haloperidol or Haldol. Janssen-Cilag were also responsible for distributing this manual, a handbook for the schizophrenic disorders, which was published under the auspices of the World Health Organization. This manual, which we will look at in some detail, recommends haloperidol as one of the promoted drugs for the treatment of schizophrenia and provides a guideline for healthcare workers for the diagnosis of schizophrenia and other mental problems. These guidelines are what is known as the Brief Psychiatric Rating Scale, which was developed by the World Health Organization. And as you can see, or you will see, the guidelines are very over-inclusive and include a range of what most people would regard as normal beliefs. brief psychiatric rating scale grades various parameters of mental abnormality from very mild to extremely severe and suggests some questions that can be asked by healthcare workers to ascertain the symptomatology, which is then rated and graded. Depression is a major market for psychiatric drugs, including drugs produced by Janssen-Cilag, but also drugs produced by SmithKline-Beecham in particular, and Eli Lilly, which Eli Lilly was the first company to produce SSRI drugs, or serotonin reuptake inhibitors, beginning with Prozac. SmithKline-Beecham, now GlaxoSmithKline, produce Arapax, which is another SSRI drug. Of course, hostility can be expected in people who have been locked up against their will. And the standard treatment for schizophrenia is, particularly acute schizophrenia, is incarceration until the person is prepared to both accept the diagnosis and accept the drugs for their treatment. Grandiosity and elevated mood are regarded as symptoms of mania and hypomania, and the treatment that is recommended in Australia for the treatment of hypomania and mania is lithium and other mood stabilizing drugs, along with antipsychotic drugs such as Haldol. These same drugs are also used for hallucinations and are the mainstay of treatment of schizophrenia, schizoaffective disorder, and mania. Here you can see the criteria for diagnosis of unusual thought content. Unusual, odd, strange, or bizarre thought content being regarded as symptoms of schizophrenia. You can see unusual beliefs in psychic powers, spirits, UFOs, or unrealistic beliefs in one's own abilities. And if one looks at the questions that they ask, it includes, can anyone read your mind? Do you have a special relationship with God? Or do you believe that X-rays and radio waves affect you?